Isabel makes love upon national monuments with style and enthusiasm and anyone at all. Isabel's done Stonehenge and the Houses of Parliament, but so far little Isabel's never played the Albert Hall. Many a monolith has seen Isabel, her bright hair in turmoil, her breast surging swell. But unhappy Albert so far denied the bright sight of Isabel getting into her stride. The fourth bridge, the Cenotaph, Balmoral and Wembley, the British Museum and the House of Lords. So many ticks in her National Trust catalogue, but so far the Royal Albert Hall has not scored. Countless cathedrals can now proudly show where Isabel's white shoulder blades have briefly reposed. Miserable Albert, still waiting for the imprint of Isabel on his parquet floor. In Westminster Abbey, she lay upon a cold tombstone, the meat in a sandwich of monumental love, with old po-faced Wordsworth unblinking beneath her, and a bright-eyed young archdeacon breathless above. Many a stony-faced statue has flickered its eyes and swayed to the rhythm of her little panting cries. But our wretched Albert never yet has known Isabel's pretty whinnying echo round his dome. On the last night of the promenade, she waved to the conductor, and there and then on the podium with scarcely a pause, with a smile and a bow and a loud "Rule Britannia," he completed her collection to enormous applause. Rapturous Albert now knows full well he's captured forever elusive Isabel. Prettily dishevelled but firmly installed and faithfully forevermore to the Royal Albert Hall. No more frantic scramblings up the dome of St. Paul's, no more dank rambles on Hadrian's Wall. With style and enthusiasm and anyone at all, Isabel makes love in the room.